What's up, guys? I am really excited. I'm working on a 2004 Porsche Carrera GT, as if it needs an introduction. We're going to talk about a few different things today. I'm going to try to keep this as quick as possible because I have a lot of work to do. But we're going to talk about how to remove swirls and sort of what you need to think about when you're doing a procedure at that. So we're going to talk about that in a second. The second thing is some little tricks that I use while I'm polishing, because when you polish a door, for example, you're not going to be able to just, do it once and then be done. You're going to have to go back and check it, and I'm going to show you little steps, little tricks on how to do that. But before that, these have carbon ceramic brakes, and when you're cleaning carbon ceramic brakes, so I'm actually washing the car and preparing it to do the polishing and the compounding, etc., that we're going to film, but I said, hey, let me hop on camera real quick. When you have these carbon ceramic brakes, you don't want to use any cleaner, not my cleaner, not anyone's cleaner, nothing. It's just a safe, smart way to do it. One of the reasons is these are very expensive. They can be anywhere from $10,000 to $20,000 per rotor and setup, depending on the car, of course, depending on the size, etc., etc. The point of the story is they're very expensive and you don't want to mess with them. The other thing is the practical reason is they don't really get all that dirty. They're not like normal rotors and normal brake pads where tons of, let's say on a BMW, there's lots of brake dust, for example, or any normal car, my truck, my van, whatever. These don't really have that because they're special, racing applications to them. So what I'm saying is you don't really need all that much power. You don't need tons of chemicals or anything. The best thing you can use is soap and water and your tools. Get in there, clean it, and just be safe. So let's hop on to the things that I really wanted to talk about today, but I wanted to just give you a little brief idea of how to clean these. All right, guys, what I really wanted to talk about today was specifically an email that I received a few weeks ago about, hey, how do I remove swirls and scratches versus love marks? And do you approach them the same? And overall, I guess the question is, how do you, detail your car? How do you compound the paint? And it's like, wow, it's hard to answer that. So what I try to do is shoot these videos and give you little slices of theory, and hopefully they all sort of can piece together, because I know a lot of you follow it. So I'll try to keep this quick. So today on this particular one, I try to take a video, I'll put it on right now, of there's swirls on the car, but on very isolated spots. Meaning, I think when I went to the dealership or wherever, someone saw some scratches or what have you and tried to get them out, but they didn't get them out properly. So I have isolated parts like that, maybe four or five of them. The rest of it has what I call love marks, which are basically when you pull it out in the sun and it's not quite perfect, but you don't see hazing or holograms or what they call a detail or signature, not something very obvious, it just doesn't look right. To me, those are two separate ways or two separate approaches to repair that. So I'm gonna try to do less talking and more showing, but it's important to understand this. So what I'm gonna do on the swirled areas is I'm going to level it with leveling fluid or compound of your choice, whatever you like, and the Meguiar's microfiber cutting pad. This happens to be a 6-inch on the Roups 21. And what I'm going to do on those specific areas is to compound that down, is to level that down, to remove the swirl, then polish out the paint. Most people think, here's the big key, that you can just polish those out. And in my opinion and my experiences, you can't really do that. You have to go through the steps, unfortunately, of doing more work. Remember, if you want perfection, it's not just a, okay, it's perfect now. There's a lot of work that's involved. So with that swirls, you got to do compound and leveling. Now, with the rest of the paint here, and I've checked it out, I've gone through and checked it, et cetera, and I put little spots, and I'll show you in the next little clip, what I'm talking about. What I do is I'm going to polish out the love mark. So when you polish that out, I'm using a foam pad. Now you can use the finishing pads. I don't really use those, but you can use a foam pad depending on the paint. Again, this is just for this specific car. And when I'm doing this, let me take a little side note here. I'm doing a test panel. So this is my test panel. Remember, rear quarter on the passenger side is just the way I've always done it. So I've done a test panel to make sure that it works, because you can fluctuate these things. So I first started out, I said, maybe I'll use some polish with a cutting pad. You see how I went in the middle? So instead of using leveling fluid with a cutting pad, which as it ends up, that's the method I'm going to use because it worked the best. I said, why don't I test a little polish or jeweler's polish with a cutting pad? See how it's like half step? So I wanted to test it out. So long and short of it is, I'm gonna compound and polish the swirls, and I'm going to just polish the rest of the car that are love marks. Two very separate things. That's a lot of information. Let me continue this and I'll show you more hands-on stuff. But that's a big concept So let that marinate.
All right, another cool thing I wanted to point out about these cars is it's basically all carbon fiber. In fact, it's a monocoque, meaning it's built as one structure. Very cool. It's essentially a race car. 560 horsepower, V10, naturally aspirated, which is a big deal for me. You guys know I'm a Porsche guy. I'm a big fan of naturally aspirated motors. Anyways, it's, for all intents and purposes, a race car, special clutch, etc. But all these pieces here, which are carbon fiber, again, I got a lot of emails about this, they're coated, they're clear coated. So you can, in fact, polish them. And this is a large kick panel. Remember we did the F40, and that was mostly paint, and obviously some carbon fiber as well, but this is exposed carbon fiber. I know a lot of people have asked me, because I think they make aftermarket hoods and things for sports cars or whatever. So I'm gonna polish this, and I'll give you a quick little tip on it. I polished the brace is in the motor there. So we did that, and I did the rear spoiler as well. And I'm doing it with my 3-inch Roops in a Meguiar's microfiber cutting pad in the 3-inch. Now, some of you might be asking, hey, why would you not cover the interior? Good question. I definitely recommend, you know, covering the interior, doing something. I've been doing this long enough that I know to dial back the amount of compound or polish, whatever you're doing. Dial it back so it's just barely enough, because you don't want to risk any sling. If you're uncomfortable with anything, put a towel and mask everything off, and just in case any sling. But I know, because I've been doing this, and I did the other side, there's not going to be any sling, and double check your work, et cetera, et cetera. But the point of the fact is, you should be polishing this as well. So here we go. Okay, so here's the second thought that I really wanted to get across to you guys. I put a little bit of, I tap, right? And then I stopped and I said, let's take a quick video here. I'm just going to compound and then polish this area. Right now I'm in the compounding phase. I haven't done anything to it, but there is a little swirl in here, probably from, somebody scratching and, with their hand to get in or whatever, and somebody tried to take it out and left swirls. So I'm about to compound it. I'll show you that step. But what's important is, it's not like you, again, this goes back to a bunch of emails. It's not like you compound it and you compound it like this. Okay, I've done that step, meaning my eyes are closed and it's done. And then the next step is polish. When I'm done compounding this, I actually go back with my light and I'll show you, and I go back and look. And I look and look and look. And if I find a little spot, I'm gonna show you a trick as to how to remember where that spot is. Because a lot of times, after looking at so many cars, you forget where that spot is. And I don't want to have to compound everything all over again. I want to try to keep as much paint on there. But if there's an extra little spot that maybe I missed, I'll show you how to remember, how to remember where that spot is to quickly get it and save yourself some time. So let me show you how to do that. All right, I've run the compound and through its course here, and it's looking great, but I have no idea. Meaning I have to remove the remaining compound, pull it off, and to the naked eye you're like, okay, yeah, this looks good. Let's start compounding the next 2x2 section. But this is the key here. You got to stop and wait. So I take off most of it. I actually leave a little strip here just to know where I ended. That's another little tip there, but. So I take it off, take my light out, and then I'll go in and I will check everything to make sure that it's all level. And you're like, well, yeah, that makes sense, duh. But a lot of times all scratches aren't created equally is kind of the joke. Meaning you might have a heavier scratch where if you have a heavy scratch here, and a light one like this, you may have gotten the light one out, but you kind of got out the heavy one, so you'd have to hit it again. But I don't want to have to go and hit this whole panel again. It doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. My goal, our goals as detailers, is to leave as much stuff here. The running joke is, people pay me to not do anything to their cars. That's the real goal. That's when you're like, oh yeah, that makes sense. I want to do the least amount to the car as possible. So the trick is this. What I do is I take a little, I take a little compound, or I go on my compounding pad. So I said, okay, there's a little scratch here. I'll come back with whatever compound I'm using. This is my leveling fluid. Bang, I'll hit that spot right there. And I go like this. Oh, you know what? I want to hit that spot a little bit. I just leave a little blug on it. Okay, it looks pretty good. If there was another one, I hit it over here. So then I go back, I clean my pad out, I go through the process, the thing, what we did on the F40, I clean with the grit guard, the whole thing. And now it's beautiful, my pad's perfect, ready to go again. But in that process, I didn't forget, and I just didn't blindly go back and say, okay, let's redo this whole panel, because this whole, everything here is perfect. I can see it, look, perfect, perfect. Right now there's DA haze, which is what you want. That's all, we talked about that in some other videos. So is it beautiful right now? No, it's where it's supposed to be. It's a little hazy because I took the paint down because it was all scratched out. You know, there was that swirl in there. But I have to go back and hit this and hit this. So a little tip is just touch your finger on some compound, make sure it's clean, whatever you're about to use, and just leave a little spot there so you remember where it is, and then reapply, and you'll do this whole area, and you do this whole area. So hopefully that gives you a little idea, some small tips. I know I'm trying to shoot shorter videos and more content, but as you can imagine, I have a lot of work ahead of me on these things, so I just like to kind of throw out tips. I'm really hoping they help. If you have any questions, shoot me an email at larry@ammonyc.com. As always, I'm so grateful for the comments, and I appreciate everyone's support, and I hope to see you out on the road this year. All right, bye-bye. All right, guys, well, here's the after shot. It's looking pretty good. We got some incredible shine going on here. It took a long time to do, but lots of fun. I'm letting it warm up for a little bit here before I put it away, I think. The owner's coming home soon to take it for a spin, so I might as well. I guess any excuse to have it running. It's such a beautiful sound. Paint looks great. Interior looks good. Hello. And let's see. Looking good, looking good. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. It was a lot of fun.